So Parsec, we know that we are basically interested in context-free grammar, deterministic context-free grammar. The maximum is O(n) cube. That is not possible. We are going for another linear time parsing. Our target is O(n). We have already found LR parser, like it is a top-down from left side. It is a good parser. The parsing table can be easily, you can compute, programmer can compute. The problem will be the language covered is not so great. But if we go for LR parser, that is from right side, we try to find out a handle and then you try to go to the top, and that is taken up the wider class. We have already know all this, so just a revision of one. Just one thing I want to mention, that I'll give a better drawing. This parsing, though we have given the top down and bottom up, but there is another type that is not in your syllabus, that is this, it is a mix, not only top down, it is a mixed type, like a famous CYK algorithm or early algorithm. I'll discuss something about it. They are dynamic programming type. They take up any place from your string. So that is it. So top down, we found it. Backtracking is absolutely no, because the complexities are huge. So we'll see it in our next slide. Yes, the parsing algorithm, the top down goal driven from the star symbol down, and bottom up data driven, that we have all top down we have finished, bottom up we have started from the symbols up. Another is Naive's dynamic programming. Naive's is, you can call it as a, whenever you go for top down on the, whenever the backtracking on, that is, you can call it Naive. You enumerated everything. That is a huge combination, a huge computational load, but that is, you can brute force, you can tell it, that is, complexity is huge. So that is a Naive method. Then by Naive method, everything will be solvable. Another is backtracking. Then it comes the, whenever the backtracking you allow sometimes, that is also, it takes huge time. Another is dynamic programming. That is, like dynamic programming, you know, factorial calculation. They store the result of earlier factorial in a table, so that whenever you want to go the factorial program a new number, they try to get it from table. So that is the technique. It is followed in the CYK algorithm and the early algorithm. So that is the CYK is a bottom-up dynamic programming. So it is not that it has to go from right to left or left to right. It is kind of where they get it. This is a dynamic programming approach. It is not linear, definitely. It is maximum complexity time O(n) cube. And another is early parsing, that is also good top-down dynamic program. They are also two type, but that is not strictly LLR and LLR. Yeah, that is not in syllabus, but it's very interesting. I can show it. So top-down with recursive descent parsing and predictive parsing, we already covered. And one more thing before top-down parsing, before jumping to the bottom-up parsing, one more interesting bottom-up parsing is there for a smaller class of grammar, that is operator precedence grammar. Let me show this one. Yeah, this is operator precedence grammar. This grammar is excellent. Here the it is no variable should be in between. Here it is not. So it is not. So here the rules are there. The all the two variables must be, there must be an operator within it. Okay, like E plus E, E minus E, E star E. So there should be an operator within it, and like all our mathematical infix notation, and no variable can go to epsilon. If it is, the grammar is too restrictive, it is too simple, but for arithmetic expression that is good, and then the simple bottom up parser would be enough. You don't need a, you only shift reduce parsing. You do not need LR0 item collection or SLR, LLR, LR1. So if you can find this kind of grammar, this is not operator precedence grammar. Why? Because it breaks the rule, because A is a variable. It is not possible. It is only possible when the grammar is written in this form. So little changes in the grammar writing also. You put your grammar, not operator precedence grammar, to operator precedence grammar. But this grammar is ambiguous, because you know, at any time it can be star, and which one plus will be taken, it's ambiguous grammar, but we'll take care of it by the some value of with operator. But anyway, this is a shift reduced parser. The operator precedence grammar. A parser reads and understands operator precedence grammar as operator. Firstly, they will define. Yes, it is just precedence of B is higher than this. This precedence relationship, we have to set it up like. Anyway, this precedence relationship, that means we want to say that star should have a higher precedence operator than plus. Plus and minus should be the same precedence. Divide should have higher precedence over plus or minus. These are weight calculations. I will show it in another class. The slide is not yet ready. I will show it then. Now, coming back to the PowerPoint slide, this is I hope so. Yeah, just a minute. Yeah. Yeah. So, this recursive, this is one is brute force, that is NAIB technique, and then called the recursive descent. And recursive descent is also not very helpful. Then we call for predictive parsing, that is that LLOR parsing. It is no backtracking, very efficient, and it's linear, but only problem is if it is a grammar like you. The expression grammar E to E plus T, like this kind of grammar, you because there is a E on both sides at the beginning, so you have to remove that left recursion by E to E, some E dash and T dash. So you have to change the rule of the grammar. That is sometimes irritating for the programmers. That is called predictive parsing. That is fully linear. Then comes the this is a not. It is not a top-down or that way bottom-up. It is a CYK. Some people say Cocky, Younger, Kasami. This is a dynamic programming approach. We'll see it is how it is come. This slide is very important, and I have taken it. Probably I have shown number of times. Like the maximum limitation is 08 cube. In fact, we know the regular language finite state machine it can be done 08. And any context free, see the context free is a huge kind of language. It's a first place a deterministic context free language, then the non-deterministic context free language. Deterministic context free language are all our programming languages made of, and there we wish to our parsing complexity must be O(n). So by first of all we have to find a deterministic context free language, then we have to find a suitable unambiguous grammar, then we have to then again if we tweaking the rules we can make it to happen to O(n) by top-down parsing and predictive deterministic parsing by O(n), and we will see it quickly by bottom-up parsing, the LR1 parsing, which is the best canonical set programming, bottom-up parsing, we can take a more higher grammar, more number of grammar in deterministic context free with complexity O(n), not O(n) cube. But if we go for, but one good thing about the CYK algorithm and early algorithm that it has put a bound on n cube, it cannot be more than this. But there are some interesting language instruction in your programming language like a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. You all know this is a context sensitive language, and there the parsing complexity is p space for np complete. So this case the compiler might fail. So we must take care. So that type of parsing problem should not come in programming language. Here, one thing probably in automata class you have little bit forgot. There in first of all, with CYK algorithm, it is said that all the rules should be maintained in Chomsky's normal form. One great thing about Chomsky's normal form that all context-free grammar, even ambiguous, deterministic, non-deterministic, can be put into Chomsky's normal form. What is Chomsky's normal form? Chomsky's normal form says the left hand side should be a single variable like in all context free grammar, but right hand side is a restriction. Right hand side in actual context free grammar there is no restriction. Any string can happen. Only one thing, the length of the string and length of the length cannot diminish. So length, see if it's a left hand side is a single variable, if the length is 1 and it the left right hand side if you take the length it should not 0. Only one exception is available, that is only star symbol can goes to epsilon. That is a context-free grammar. But Chomsky's normal form says that they actually, the writer said only two variable or a single termin. Two variable, single termin, only star can go epsilon. So what is the great about Chomsky's normal form is, it is much easier to implement in programming language. You know, the all programming language, you can handle the binary tree. This is a kind of binary tree. Complexities are less. So, in fact, in all parsing, we may have to convert the Chomsky's normal form. The Chomsky's normal form is all grammar can be converted to Chomsky's normal form. So, let's see if it is Chomsky's normal form, what will happen. Yes. This is CYK algorithm. See here, CYK name after this is John Koch, Daniel Younger, and Tada Kasabi. Here, the notable point is the algorithm sidesteps the need to try every possible tree by exploiting the fact a complete sentence. Actually, we are also human, we try to understand. Say, if you have a weak language, we do not try to first understand by the top down, we try to not understand the whether it is a what is where the. What is the noun clause, what is the verb clause, then verb clause they may contain noun clause. We generally do not do. We generally try to understand the meaning of the words. If the meaning of the words, we try to associate. It's a bottom-up approach. The CYK also takes the bottom-up approach. You try to, this algorithm sizes the need to try every possible tree by exploiting the fact a complete sentence is made up of combining sub-clauses, or equivalently parts is made of combining sub. So it's a bottom-up approach. Again, it not from the left side or right side, it, anywhere they found the symbols which can be converted to the tree, tree is only valid if its subtrees are valid. Yes, that is true. So if it's fully parsed, then all the subtrees should be valid. The algorithm works from the bottom of tree upwards, like bottom up parsing, not from the right side. It may be from anywhere, like in bottom up parsing, from the right side we try to get the handle. That is the most problem. Storing possible valid subtrees as it goes and building the larger subtrees from these components without need to restore the calculator. So we have to, if it is successful, we take this. This is called dynamic programming algorithm. Very interesting. Say here, like a sentence. Say we have Jeff trains geometry students. So this is Jeff is a noun clause. It's a verb phrase. Trains is the verb, again a noun phrase, and again two noun, geometry and students. So even a grammar in Chomsky's normal form, we can turn our attention to parsing sentence. The parsing algorithm return a valid parse tree like this one in figure 6 of the sentence, a valid analysis. So that's great. So how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. And one interesting is, see the nodes is 1, 2, 3, 4. And how many internal nodes are there? Internal nodes are here 1, 2, 3. These three are internal. So anywhere if the grammar follows the Chomsky's normal form, if there are n nodes, so there are 4 nodes, there must be internal nodes are 3. So VP, V and down, these three are internal nodes. So that is very interesting. We'll see it. So internal nodes is always, if the grammar is Chomsky's normal form, is there n terminals, there must be 3, n minus 1 is the internal nodes. Let's see the next. Here it comes. See, if it is a two nodes, there can only one possible. If you find a sentence with the two nodes, if the grammar is Chomsky's normal form, definitely it has only one derivation. This is it. But if the grammar has three nodes, 1, 2, 3, then you have two way you can get it, either this way or that way. If the grammar has four nodes, like 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you can, the combination is huge. This is one, this one, this one, this one, this one. So in all the cases, say either when the nodes is here two, that parse tree can be only one and internal node is one. And whenever it is a internal, external node is three, internal node is two, internal node is, and there can be only two possible, internal node is one, sorry, this is 1, 2, 3. And internal node is, this one is internal, this one is internal. So, by combination is 2. And whenever there is a Chomsky's normal form, is a 5, your symbols, n terminals. So, there are combination of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you find that way, there's a huge number of combination. In fact, if you take the if we take the full combination, if it is a, say we found it, if it's three terminals, we have two parts tree. If we have a the four terminals, we have a five. If it is six, there is a 14, and if there are seven, there is a 42. So this is the huge way the number increases. You know, generally whenever you make a program, it definitely consists of around 1, 2, 3. It may consist of 100 terminals. So this is the way of combination. So it is absolutely impossible for it's computationally very high if we go for haphazard parsing. So this is, I am trying all combination. These are all combination of parse tree, and one of them would be definitely valid for unambiguous this thing. So that is the reason. That's the logic. We go for only from left to right or right to left. So because these are the valid, if there are any simple grammar, if there is even n terminals. So here, say if we have a nodes only, here nodes is only 3. Here nodes are only 4. Where the terminals, here nodes are only 5. If it's 5, there are 14 parsing tree. If we can try by name method, so that is the beauty. That is the beauty. So we are stick to top down or bottom up parsing. Not right now. We are not going to CYK now. Yeah, that is another great example from the he is the man, Noam Chomsky, who invented, he almost single-handedly invented this grammar of this. But there are some references that some 400 BC, in Panini's Lokas also, there are some grammar concept is there. But unfortunately, that is not looked up. So it is Noam Chomsky single-handedly done it. So that is two sentences there. Like colorless green ideas sleep furiously. It is syntactically correct. Colorless green ideas. So sleep furiously, but no meaning. Semantically no meaning, but syntactically correct. And another is furiously sleep ideas green colorless. So see, here the English language syntax rule is broken, so it doesn't mean anything. But here, see, colorless, you mean colorless green ideas sleep furiously. It is a syntactically correct sentence. Maybe it is good poetic language, but there's some semantic meaning is difficult. So that these particular examples, Noam Chomsky used his famous 1957 paper. You know, there are two important papers in automata theory and language. One is 1936 paper, 1936-37 paper by Alan Turing about the Turing machine, and another is language, whole language portion, like type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3. This all concept is given by Noam Chomsky by this paper. There it shows this colorless green idea sleep furiously is a perfectly syntax, no, a syntax error is there, but semantic meaning is not there. We'll see our subsequent classes after finishing bottom-up parsing. By bottom-up parsing, we'll take another 1 or 2 days and in the presentation, then we'll go to the semantic checking. Semantic checking is much easier. There the whether does it meaning anything or not, and the casting operator like float to integer, integer float, string to integer, all these things, whether legal or not, all these things will be taken care in the semantic. Yeah, but one thing might wonder you, what is the difference between the shift duties parser and why you are making complicated in alert zero parser, where particularly on the stack it will be pushed to not only the symbol. Yes, see, always a bottom up parser, whenever you are using stack, at the last your start symbol should be there. And before, we'll the blank stack with the dollar there, and like in your top-down parsing, we'll put a on a, from the left side into it, and notice we try to find it out what is inside the stack. You know the how to get the idea of the stack. Stack should be visible from the only from the top side. So we always push a state, and the state number is state number 0, state number 1, state number 3, that you have to calculate it from a parsing table. Whenever you put a terminal into a stack, we definitely push to a state number. That is a table we have to make. That table has two part. One is go to state version, which state and what action you can do. One is action part, whether you are shifting or reducing, or whether you are rejecting, whether you are accepting, that's the action part. And another is the which state you are going, that state you have to put it on the top of the stack. The next time that state symbol will be compared. So these are the action part. So this is the LR parser. I'll give it here. So we, for LRs in automation, we try to find it out in what state condition it could be. So there is some, we have to take some extra additional single step, and we have to calculate the LR0 automation. LR0 basically key points are construct the LR table. Start with augmented grammars. Like you remember your Chomsky's number form, whenever you are converting Chomsky's number form, we are taking an extra symbol, a star symbol S to S0. Same kind of a augmented grammar S dash to S, and general items from production. Are dot into all positions, general item set or configuration set from items. There are parser states. Generate state transition from function successor, state and symbol. So here, not only in the stack, first symbol will go, then the state. Top available thing is the state. So you always compare state with the input buffer, the terminal. Build action and go to tables. Tables implement shift, reduce parsers. It is basically shift, reduce, accept, reject. View state and transition is a finite automaton. There is important concept of not a, this is, you all know DFA. Actually, it's a state number is come from the finite state automation DFA. An item represents how far a parser is recognized for its one stool in RHS. Yes, that is. Whether the dot is at the beginning, end, or the this thing. If it is at the end, you can reduce it.